The penultimate day of competition in the Slovakian leg of this 27th Universiade. And after 2 days of grey and snow, at last a little bit of sunshine to kiss the peaks of the Tatra Mountains. There's a fascinating battle to look forward to in the team Gunderson. It's the last day of action from the biathlon as well. We look at the two mass starts. And it's the last event for the women in the cross country, the 15K mass start. Will it be Russia or Kazakhstan?
Fifth and final day of the biathlon competition in the 27th Universiade. We're in the Lower Tatra Mountains in Osrblie at their magnificent revamped biathlon center. Final men's race of the competition, 15 kilometer mass start. Now, of course, this is quite a recent addition to the biathlon calendar, 2006. Under starters' orders, and the best 30 from the beach competition pair off. Setting the early pace, Ukrainian Dmytro Rusinov, followed by the Russians, Yuri Shopin, wearing the number one jersey. A stellar field. Rusinov, of course, had won the opening event, the 20-kilometer individual. He was shadowed by the two Russians, Yuri Shopin and Vadim Filimonov. They came into the race in form. They were the two golden members of the mixed relay. First shooting, prone of course, the first two. And he was the Norwegian, Hutkins Falland, with a perfect 5 out of 5. He certainly hauled himself into contention. Another Norwegian was giving his good account of himself, number 11, Erle Martin Erdal. Yet it was Vitaliy Kilchytskyy was helping out the Russian Vadim Filimonov. Cooperation seemed to be the name of the game in the early stages. Come the first stand-up shooting, the third. There was a strong wind, and that was to take its toll. The Norwegians, they seemed to handle the pressure in the first two shootings, but not standing up. That meant a new leader. Rusinov, 5 out of 5. And Kilchytskyy matching him. Superb shooting by those two. And it's true what they say. The stand-up shooting in a mass start really is the tipping point. This turned into a fantastic duel. They were neck and neck. Gradually, Kilchytskyy began to assert his domination. He'd won silver 2 years ago in Trentino in the sprint, and he was about to add the gold medal in the mass start. Terrific performance by him. 43 minutes, 17.1 seconds. And the man in second, Dmytro Rusinov, well, he didn't seem to mind the silver medal. Good sportsmanship. And look at that. Joy untold for the two Ukrainian medalists. And why not? And look at this terrific final lap by the Russian Yuri Shopin. He celebrates as well. He's delighted. And he adds that bronze to his gold from the pursuit and the mixed relay. And let's not forget the bronze he picked up in the pursuit.
Thank you very much for your resultati. Congratulations. You'll be so spread your wings and fly.
On here at to Strbske Pleso, the focus back on the cross-country skiing. It's the last day of competition for the ladies, and they have the mass start of 15 kilometres. More fresh snow tumbling overnight. The course administrators hard at work to make sure it's not too powdery. Big field expected to start this race. Over 50 skiers will line up at the beginning. The favourites, of course, the Russians. They've dominated proceedings throughout the cross-country events. But look out also for the Kazakhstani, Anastassiya Slonova. She won the gold in the sprint, silver in the 5K. She's certainly one of the stars, if not the star, of this competition. The Russians, led by Svetlana Nikolaeva. They've also got Anna Povolyeva, Lilia Vasilyeva, and Victoria Karkina, as well as Anastassiya Vlasova on the start line. So really a very, very strong Russian team as well. The French might be buoyed a little bit. They picked up a bronze medal in the team relay as well. They'll be looking for a good start to this race. And off they go. That's Nikolaeva wearing number one at the start, wearing number one. Marion Bouillet of France wearing two. Pretty clean start for all the girls. Climbing up the first hill. It's four circuits of a 3.75-kilometre course, and that course involves one really, really nasty hill, and that's likely to separate the real contenders. It's Evelina Marshish who led the way from the start. She was silver medalist in the sprints. The pole going along nicely, but right on her heels, Svetlana Nikolaeva and Anastassiya Slonova. Marshall's looking comfortable. That's Slonova wearing one there. Just a little battle developing between those two. Wearing number seven, one of the other Russians, Victoria Karkina. And wearing 19, the French girl, Iris Pessy. She was one of the relay team that took bronze yesterday. Nikolaeva and Slonova and Marsish breaking away a little bit, and there is Slonova with the big decisive break. She made it 1.6 kilometres from home. She really opened up the throttle and came home to win in 44 minutes 47.1, 8.8 seconds clear of Svetlana Nikolaeva. Silver medal for her. She's won gold in the team sprint and the relay, bronze in the sprint, so no individual gold for her this time around, and that is a bronze medal for Evelina Marsish. She took silver in the sprint, so happy to pick up a medal, but what a performance from Anastassiya Slonova. She really has been outstanding at this Universiade. That's how it finished. That's the top 10. Victoria Karkina just dropping off, unable to press for the medals at the end, finishing 28 seconds behind the winner. So, for once, it's not Russia who will take a top step on the podium. It's this woman, Anastassiya Slonova, with her second gold medal of the Universiade. Nikolaeva takes silver. Marsish takes bronze. Another terrific performance to close the ladies' event at this 27th Universiade.
Fifth and final day of competition at the Universiade Biathlon Competition. We're in Osrblie in the Lower Tatra Mountains. Very much looking forward to the final competition, the women's 12.5 kilometre mass start. Home hopes were high in the form of their golden girl, Paulina Fialkova, of course, who picked up the gold medal in the sprint. She was wearing bib number one alongside her, Ekaterina Avakumova, the defending champion, wearing number three, Jitka Landová from the Czech Republic. Very nearly came a cropper, did the Czech, crossing skis with a rival. Thankfully, that came to nothing. It was Landová who decided that the best place to be in a mass start was out up front. Fialkova had the same idea, and all eyes were on the first shooting. Jokova made a bad start, missing her first. She soon recovered, 4 out of 5. Kazakh Vishnevskaya and Bondova enjoyed clear rounds. A quick pit stop by Landova just to refuel, take an energy drink and liquids on board. She was being tracked by the Kazakh Vishnevskaya. Second prone shooting, and once again Landova shooting clear. Vishnevskaya fortunately missing one, incurring a penalty loop, 150 meters, which cost her some 20 seconds. The wind gradually picked up during the competition. Landova, by the time she got to her third shooting, which was standing up, she was out on her own at the range. 4 out of 4. But then she made her first mistake. No matter. She was overtaken by fellow Czech, Eva Puskarčíková. He shot clear. But Landova always had her fellow Czech in her sights. Landova was first to the final, the fourth and final shooting range. Puskarčíková, well, she had problems with her rifle. Landova capitalized. Once again, a good start. 4 out of 4, just like at the last standing shooting. And once again, she missed the last one. Window of opportunity for her fellow Czech, Puskarčíková. But unfortunately, she wasn't able to capitalize. And that meant any pressure that Landova might have been feeling was completely lifted from her shoulders. The pressure was off, and she was left to coast home for a successful defense of her mass start title, and of course the gold medal. Congratulatory wave. Fellow Czech, Puskarčíková, taking the silver medal, some distance behind, it has to be said, 55.2 seconds. And some 10 seconds behind her, the Ukrainian, Bondar, completing the podium.
Welcome to the third and final Nordic Combined competition in these Winter Universiades. It's a Team Gundersen today, and Poland are going for a third gold in Strbske Pleso. They've dominated the Nordic Combined so far, and let's see if they can make it 3 out of 3. This is how they go. There's a mixed team, as well as teams from Ukraine, Czech Republic, Germany, Russia, Japan, and Poland on the 100-meter hill. 90 meters is the K point. Ernest Yahin for Russia. Didn't go in the Gundersen. He was 6 in the mass start with 87.5 and 84, and that's a better leap for him. Tobias Seaman of Germany. He's a good jumper. That's his strong point, and that's a good leap from him. 96 meters. That's the best so far. Agury Shimizu, 2013 individual Gundersen bronze. Can he get another medal today? He needs a good jump. That's not bad either. Around 90 meters. Just a bit short, but that's a useful jump from him. So the Poles just looking to go on and on. Mateusz Wantulok, a mass start bronze, 91 and 94 meter jumps. Let's see what he can do there. And that's pretty good as well. That's nearly 95 meters. 117.8. Also, after the ski jumping element, looks like the Poles are in a good position again, although their lead is only going to be 9 seconds and 14 clear of Germany. It should be a really exciting cross-country event. in Strbske Pleso. It's 3 by 5 kilometers for the men, and that's how they stand. It's close between the top three. We're underway with Poland looking to go for gold again. They've been dominant here. Sisla winning gold in the individual, Gunderson and Mass start, and David Welde silver in both of those events. Kupczak got the bronze in the individual, Gunderson and Vantulok for Poland. They're dominating, but it's going to be tough here because Yamamoto has taken the lead. He was third in the mass start, only fourth overall. He's a good cross-country skier, is Yamamoto. Here's the change. This is going to be a real scrap. Japan want gold, as do Germany. Poland have got a battle on their hands if they're going to keep this clean sweep going. In the second leg, and Germany are ahead with Seaman, and it's a real battle between Germany and Japan, and Poland in contention, and the Czech Republic suddenly in third. Zeman just getting ahead of Shimizu. Remember Watanabe, he was fourth in that mass start. David Welde was quickest in the mass start, ending up with silver, and he's going to be the anchor leg for Germany. But it's Japan at the moment with a game in their hands. Can they hold on? In 2013, they got a bronze medal to Japan. Poland, no surprise, winning the gold. This is a wonderful battle you see. David Welde there, tucked in quite nicely between the two. Japan ahead. The three, very tight there. Remember, Poland started with a 9-second lead over Japan and 14 over Germany. That seems a long time ago, doesn't it? And David Welde, he's got two silvers so far, but there's a gold in sight. This will be a wonderful story for him. He's 6 seconds ahead of Watanabe. This is going to be a battle for gold. And the team of David Welde, Johannes Wasel, and Tobias Seaman, they might just get a first gold for Germany, and they're going to get it. And it's, what a story. David Welde, he was being denied by Sisla twice, but this time Germany have it. And it's their first gold in any competition in this Universiade. You see how much it means to them. Germany with the gold, Japan 10 seconds back. They'll be pretty happy with that. No Poland, though. And it's Russia getting the bronze. What a competition it was. And Germany get the gold. You'll be so spread your wings and fly.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where to friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.